Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and survivors, and of course, all Earthlings. Welcome back to Paul Plays Minecraft. Hope you had a nice weekend. Today's Monday, so back to the grind, as it were. Either back to school, or back to work, or maybe back to sitting on the porch with your ice-cold lemonade, with your feet up and your iPad 2, watching the show here because you're retired or independently wealthy, or maybe you're unemployed. Or skipping school, or whatever. I'm not here to judge, really. I'm just here to play. What am I looking for? Sandstone. There it is. I've got enough here. Let me just bring that in case. Actually, 32 should be plenty. All right, anyway, yeah, the plan today, my friends, is to build Booger Fleming's terrarium. So we went to the over to the local swamp, and we brought Booger Fleming back. He is the escaped convict that I found in the stronghold not too long ago. Okay, I think I have everything we need. Let's get out of here. Although, oh, right, glass. Yeah, see, I did all this last week, and I had forgotten what I was doing. But I was making up supplies for this job. But I didn't quite finish. So yeah, we're going to build up Booger's terrarium outside. We're going to make a nice big glass home for him. It's going to be very swampy, just like home. And we're going to do that right over by the train, so that when we go to work every day, we get to say hello. And we want to go this way. So I have a chosen location, which is right over here. Oh, I can hear him. Hear a little booger in there? There he is. I don't want to let him out, though. He's a slap-happy fellow, isn't he? Booger, what are you doing in there, anyway? Okay, don't ask, don't tell. Okay, here's all the supplies I gathered so far for this job. Are we clear here? I just don't never know what's walking around out here in the fields. So why don't we get started? Oh, good. I've got plenty of glass. And I think I'm going to need some glowstone. In fact, I know I'm going to need 4 pieces of glowstone for the corner. So I have kind of an idea in my head here how this terrarium is going to look. But we're going to make it very, like I said, very swampish. Now, we do have to be careful with our friend Booger here because Booger's slimes tend to fall and die a lot. So we have to make this, we have to make it slime-proof. And I'm just thinking in my head, it's kind of like child-proofing a home. And if you have kids of your own, then you know exactly of what I speak. If you don't, or maybe you have a little sibling, maybe a little brother, or a little sister, or a little cousin. No, my rail! Or something. So you kind of have an idea what child-proofing is, and that basically is when you have a baby and you bring it home, him or her home, you really need to make sure that you minimize any kind of deadly risks around the home. Anyways, hey guys, what's up? It's so nice to have names now. Look at Maya, Yukon, Kuzco. Now, I don't know if you guys remember or have really picked up on this, but before we had the names, I used to stare at my animal for about 2 or 3 seconds before I remember the names of these things. Because I have so many animals and so many Let's Plays, I tended to forget what their names were. And I had to think about it just very briefly. Very, very briefly. It was only a 2 or 3 second pause, so you may not have even noticed. I just want to grab some of this stuff too. Or maybe you did, and you just are too polite to mention it to me. So I thank you for that. Alright, we're just going to make a infinite water supply here. But getting back to slime proofing. So yeah, when you have a kid, you really have to think about all those little knickknacks around the house and sharp edges and heavy things on shelves that you take for granted as an adult or someone with, you know, fine motor skills and common sense, which most babies and toddlers don't really have. So you have to think about what might happen. Future site, Booger's Terrarium. We can take that now. So that is a consideration we have to do here too. And so here's how this is going to work. I'm going to make a frame around the bottom. That's going to be sandstone. And then the whole thing is going to be glass. It's going to be like a big fish tank, but with swampy insides. Now, I have a lot of experience with terrariums, being a young boy, having a few terrariums myself. Now, how close do we want to... Let's go out 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Is that 9? Should we have it that close to the rail? Yeah, that's nice. Get close and personal here with a little friend. So I think it's going to be 9 by 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Is that right? It's Monday. I don't count Mondays. Hurts my brain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, that's good. So now we're just going to dig this out. And we're going to have a sandstone and glowstone bottom. And then the rest of it, the walls. And I don't know if I'm going to put a rooftop on it. Probably not. I'm going to have a tree in here. I'm going to have a little tree and make it look very swampy with vines hanging down from it. In the very center, probably. But the frame here is going to be nice and bright with sandstone. And then to light it up at night, we're going to have the glowstone in the corners. This is just an idea I had in my head. We'll see how it comes out. Now, getting back to the slime proofing and child proofing, I can't have any like high shelves or any blocks that Booger can climb and then fall and kill himself on. So it has to be low, and we're going to use a lot of synthetic materials like fake water because they can drown themselves. So I've got the lapis blocks for fake water, and you'll see how this works out in the end, but should be interesting. So this will be kind of our little fish tank wall here. I had a 30-gallon long fish tank. That was my terrarium. And I remember catching a lot of little local aminals. Salamanders and toads and frogs and turtles. And I've probably gone through 4 or 5 various terrariums over a period of my life. As a kid. Again, most of them were captured local animals, so they were natives to the area. But I remember I had actually gone out one time and purchased newts. Is that 9? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. And I remember I didn't have a terrarium quite yet for those guys, so you know what I did? I put them outside in like a little tub. Yeah. And guess what? They climbed out. I think my mom bought them for me. And they weren't cheap. They're these exotic little buggers that were probably, oh, I don't know how much. I don't know, maybe at the time 10, 15 bucks or something like that. And the little buggers escaped. So we went out to go back to get food for them or something. I can't really remember, but I remember coming back and looking in the little tank that we put in. Not tank, just a tub, a little plastic tub. They were gone. My mom wasn't happy. I wasn't really too happy about it either. But lesson learned. All right, so there's our fake water. Remember, we are going to have to use a lot of synthetics in this build so that Booger doesn't hurt himself. But I am going to put some water in here and lily pads on top of the water to make it a little more authentic looking. Just trying to visualize. I want to put some reeds. So, how about if we do, let's put some water here. Now remember, the water has to abut the reeds. Otherwise, they won't be able to plant them. Wouldn't mind having the water come right up to the tree, honestly. Let's see how this works. How about if I put water here, next to the tree, and then put this here. Although I want it, I don't want it too square. That looks goofy. If it's too square, I want it to look a little more natural. Maybe like this. Booker's gonna love this place. All right, let's put up the reeds. And we can put a reed here and a reed here. And a reed here. I don't want too many reeds, honestly. But, okay. I might adjust that later. And let's put a lily pad. We're gonna have, let's see, we've got some lily pads here. Let's put a lily pad here, lily pad there. How about a little pad here? A little pad? Do I hear somebody? Look at my poor little pets over there. So jealous. They hate Booger Fleming. I wouldn't be surprised if they make attempts on his life by making this place a little less slime-proof somehow. Excuse me. I don't know what they're going to pull off, but I don't trust them, particularly Cuzco. Cuzco? Yes, look at me. Yes, I'm talking to you. Be nice to Booger. Okay. I see in your eye right now. I see the little gears turning, wondering how he can take Booger out. Don't deny it. Heard that. All right. How about we put another lily pad somewhere here? I've got one more lapis. How about water over here on this side of the tree? Let me think about that. I don't think I need the axe right now. Let's get rid of you. I think it'd be nice to have the tree surrounded by water. I might have to get some more lapis. We'll see. That looks okay. Maybe another water here and one here. But I'm going to have to get some more lapis. Although I guess I could take a piece right now. If I put another lily pad. Let's put a lily pad right here. There we go. And then, what if we do like maybe this? How about that? Yeah, I'm gonna need one more lapis for there, I think. Right here. I don't want to put any more. Too many lily pads over here looks kind of goofy, but I don't want to overdo it with the pads. Let's try that. Let's just try that one there in that corner. And then another lapis here. All right, I might have to do some fine tuning, but I think that looks swampy and waterish. Maybe another blue here. Just to, so it's not so square. You know what I mean? All right, that's good enough for now. So, let us now... Oh, I wanted to put some mud in here, too. Right, mud. Because this is kind of muddy. All right, swamps are muddy. Again, we have to use some synthetics here, so just bear with me. We're trying to be as safe as possible for our little fella, a little friend. So, little patches of mud. Here and there. This would be nice and soft for him so he doesn't kill himself on it. It's going to be 100% certified slime proof. All right. Want to keep some of that grass in there, of course. Put a little piece of mud here. There we go. I think we're going to need some more mud over here. Yeah, nice and muddy. Nice and muddy. Just the way a slime might like it. And I think we need some mud over here on this side. What do you think? And maybe a bit of mud here. Okay, I might have to get some more mud. Oh, yes! Alright, awesome. Okay. Quick tater tot break here, fellas. Whew, it's hard work. Uh-huh. All right, now let's do our tree. I've got some oak leaves. And Let's go up a little bit here. Let's see. I'm wondering if we should go up. How high should we go up? Now, we're going to have to be careful with the vines. I do want to put vines. But we don't want the vines to be climbable by Booger, because if he climbs a vine and then he falls off, he's going to die. So I'm wondering... how's this going to work? Yeah, that could be a problem. All right. I'm going to have to think about that. We'll have to keep an eye on the vines. So why don't we put the tree... let's see, how high do we want these to go? Like here? Might be too high. I don't want the tree to be too tall. Let's just step back and take a peek. That might be a little too tall. Let's come down one. Let's go like this. We're going to have... it's going to look like the actual swamp tree, which I believe... there's only two layers of leaves. We've got a lower layer. Is that low? Yeah, that's good. That's perfect. Right? We've got kind of a lower layer. We'll leave the corners undone. I hear you, Slimy. Oh, that don't call him Slimy. He hates that. Booger, I hears you, Booger. We'll get you out of there momentarily. Poor little Booger. He's so misunderstood. Yeah, because we want to keep one space. We don't want... although, maybe what we might have to do is let the vines grow over the glass? No. No, that wouldn't look good at all. I think I want to make it more like that. I should have grabbed my shears. Whee. Okay, sun's coming up. Excellent. Yeah, I'm surprised nobody came after me building this place through the night. The wood on top might have to go. That one little bit of wood up there, I think, is extraneous. And stop moving. And I think we can get rid of that. What do you think? And instead, let's put leaves in here. Just checking the perimeter. You have to be aware of what's happening around you. I guess that looks better, I think. Okay, so now we have some ferns and some things. We have to put up the... let's finish up the glass walls because we're going to go too high most of the way around. We'll eventually go all the way around too high, but I'm going to leave a couple of openings here so I can get in and out while I build. And I'll have to have some sort of method to get in and out of here to, you know, feed him, come in and say hi, play a little bit with him. So somewhere we're going to have to put a door. My guess would be, I guess, back here. Right? In the rear somewhere so that it doesn't obscure the view. Maybe a door right here. Trap door or something. Of course, we are going to have to get him in there. Now, okay, he shouldn't drown on those water blocks because they have the lily pads. I think he's okay there. Let's go get some more decoration. And our terrarium, maybe... complete. We want some vines, of course. We want some ferns. I think we're done with that. Done with that. I think we're done with that. Don't need the dirt. And some grass. So I did a lot of clipping with my clippers. How about bushes? We have bushes? Again, we can't make it too high. Remember, childproof. Childproof. We don't want them pulling, like, I remember doing that with my own kids, seriously. It's scary bringing home a kid. Oops, wrong one. How would you know? You just don't know what to do. How about a couple of vines on that side? A couple of vines on this side. And maybe one vine in the back. But I remember having this end table, coffee table that my wife and I bought when we lived in Arizona. And it was before we had kids. And that thing had sharpest edges. And I don't remember what we did with it. I think we just either flipped it upside down or we kind of put it in a corner where it was safe. But then you've got all the stuff, all the knickknacks and the vases, anything glass, big heavy bookends on the on shelves and stuff. All these things you have to think about. And then doors. You cover up the doorknobs with these fake doorknobs. And it totally confuses everyone. It's pretty funny. Like kids are like, I think you'll open a door. Because it's fake, kid. It just keeps spinning and spinning and spinning. I don't know. What about the grass? What do you think? A little grass in front. And then latches on all the cabinet doors. So they don't open cabinets and get into all the deadly chemicals like Drano and have a big sip of that. That would do wonders for a kid's internals. You think it's easy, don't you? You kids. You think it's easy being a parent. This is what we have to think about. Everything. Everything. Okay, so that's good. I think we're done here. I think that looks pretty slick. So how about we go get Booger and get his input? I'm still worried about those vines. If he climbs the vines, I'm not sure if Slime can climb a vine. And if he can, that could be a problem. I'll have to take him down. We'll see. All right, let's block this off. We don't want him climbing out. And we got to get rid of this water. He's going to drown himself getting over here. Dumb like that. I think I'll add a door later. All right, to William. Let's go, Booger. Now, okay, Booger. I'm going to let you out. I don't want to hit you with anything. So, let's see. There we go. Hello. Come on, Boogie. Booger Fleming. All right, I thought you lost your name. I thought you lost your identity. I thought you went feral again, being in that little spot all by yourself. There you go. What do you think of your new house? Look at that. Right in the water. Pops right back out. That is the exact behavior I was looking for. Good. So nice. Maybe fern or grass here. On that little dirt. Oh, that's, you know what? I'm not going to get any grass there. It's going to be dirt forever. That's going to bug me and many other folks. So let's just... Booger, come over here for a sec, please. I don't want to hit you with anything. Let's just let this grow, and I'll come back and replace that with the synthetic dirt later. Mud. I could put soul sand in here. All right, what do you think of your home, pal? All right, now, the test. When those vines start to grow, that will be the ultimate test to see if this really, truly is 100% booger-proof. Now we're going to need a sign. Booger Fleming. Does that kind of impersonalize it? Make him look like he's really on display, which we don't want him to feel that way. Booger Fleming. That's all right. That's okay. Booger Fleming, and I need one more sign. In case I get inspected. If child services, slime services comes by, they happen, you know, sometimes they come by and they have spot inspections. This is very important. And I'll put this over on this side. And we're going to call this certified. Certified 100%, oops, 100% slime proof. It's not really, because I still have to test. Let's bring that back down. Certified 100%. 100% slime proof. So again, slime proof doesn't mean that slimes can't get in or out. It just means that it's childproof. That's the term they use. Safe. It's safe. Now, I'm thinking maybe I don't want to go any higher with the glass, but what I might do, and like this. So it would be something like that, right? Like this. Kind of like a top to it, but not really. It's a false top because the tree is still there. What do you think? Like at the like open air like that? Or with that? I kind of like the open air, honestly. That might look more like a terrarium. A full terrarium. But we'll see how that affects the we'll see how that affects the vines. The vines should still grow. I don't think it'll stop the vine from growing. But we'll see. Okay, I hope you like it, Booger. He seems happy. Yep, I just have to put a door so I can come in and say hey once in a while. Very nice. Okay, Booger's terrarium. All right. Well, I think I'm going to go put all this stuff away and come up with a plan for the next thing. I still need a horsey, of course. Hold on, let me check my notes. Oh, right. Frame with Booger's brother, Snot. He was killed in episode 29 at the Stronghold. I've been meaning to do that. We can put that over here in memory of Snot. We'll put it up on the tree so that Booger can remember his little brother. I actually have that slime ball. Let's just take a ride on the reading. And this needs to be fixed. Needs to be modified a little bit, I think. Certain locations, but actually it works pretty well now. Oh cow! Oh cow! Oh cow! Oh cow! That would have been disastrous. For me. I mean, you know, cow, yeah. It could get much worse for the cow. As it is, but they do a lot of damage to those minecarts. Head-on collisions. Alright, let's put that bucket away there. Don't need that. Don't really need these signs right now. So, we're going to go get Booger's brother. Snot. I actually killed him outright without a thought. Remember, we were in the stronghold and I was looking around like, oh, slime! And I just whipped out the sword and chopped him in half. Deaded. Instantly. Because he wasn't in a prison cell like little... There he is. Like our little friend Booger was. You see, Booger was in the cell and I felt bad the moment I saw him. Like, oh, this is terrible. How did this happen? This poor little fella. Of course, we know the story and how it happened, but at the time, it concerned me. So I wanted to break him out. And here he is. But his brother, unfortunately... Whoops, no. That didn't quite work out so well for Snot. So why don't we go and... it's chasing me. It's getting dark again. Let's go commemorate his little brother. Double press. Alright, let's put Booger's little brother. How about we put it right here for him? Of course, I don't have a sign. Although, maybe I should put a sign too. I could put the sign beneath it. Alright, Snot. Come on, pal. So sorry. So sorry I did that to you. There we go. Okay. And now, let's go get So we got another bush. One bush. Here. Yeah, I'm gonna need like a ladder, just put a ladder over here or something. Might be a heck of a lot easier than jumping. That and that vine. I don't cover the whole front too much with vines. Okay, there you go. There's your little brother, buddy. Snot. Should probably put a sign there too so we know. I'll do that next time. I think I just put my signs away. I did. All right, well, let me know what you think about that little terrarium here and whether or not the glass, if you like the glass on top here like that as kind of a roof or not. I think the open air like this is better, particularly since poor little Booger here, he enjoys the rain, and when it rains, he'll get, you know, splashed in his little face here. He can look up at the rain and catch it in his mouth. Does he have a mouth? No. Well, then he can catch him in his eyes or whatever. Enjoy the rain, but if I have a roof on it, he may not be able to do that. Okay, so Booger's Terrarium. And now I have to think about what we're going to do next. Hold on, let me check my to-do list. Be right back. Okay, check this out. So, I left the game momentarily to check my to-do list. Came back, and Booger escaped from the terrarium. He is indeed a master escape artist. Okay, this could be a problem, Booger. Come on, let's get you back inside. All right, I don't know what happened there. That was weird. Come on, Booger, get in here. Don't jump. Oh my God. Booger, no. Oh, you stay. Oh, you're going to give me a heart attack. This place is supposed to be. All right, you know what? I might have to change that sign. I might have to change that sign after all. Yes, I'll come back for that. I'll come back for that piece of dirt. Sure I will. Oh boy. Yeah, this could be a problem. By the way, this video is actually over 30 minutes, so we are ending. We're more like 97%. Whoops, certified. Certified 97% slime proof. So we'll see what happens. It was only when I... Oh, perfect. Here comes the rain, little buddy. See how much he likes it? He's so much happier and hoppier. I know everybody wants me to get that dirt, but it's too dangerous right now. Hold on. Let me turn that rain sound off. Okay, actually, I can't turn the rain sound off, but I can do this. I don't have Optifine installed right now, so on Snapshot. So anyway, yeah, 97% proof. And as long as I don't exit the game near him... Let's take a ride. As long as I don't exit the game near him, I'm imagining I should be okay with that. Because he must have respawned in the game when the game started. He respawned outside of the glass. Whoa! You turkey! Nice job, thank you. I had a feeling he was gonna get me. I need to work on my shooting and riding skills. Shooting from horseback. Okay. So we're done here, folks. This is a pretty long episode. So I hope you enjoy. And once again, happy Monday. And we'll see you next time. I'm kind of thinking about getting two of these done a week if possible. I've got kind of a new schedule. Look at that arrow in my cap. That is pretty funny. How did he shoot me on the top of my noggin? That's a trick shot if I ever did see one. So I will, I'll see you next time. I've got a new schedule, and I'll talk about that probably in a different video. All right, anyway, we'll see you. Bye. At least I can run fast. Oh no, there's a white werewolf. And oh, ow. Okay, get into the water now. I'm gonna go hide inside the village. Looks like the sun is on the rise. This is good. Oh my gosh. Okay, don't turn around. Whatever you do, don't turn around. Go, sprint. And we have ghosts in the village. Okay, you need to eat some rat. Maybe if I get out of sight. Healing. Whew. Henry, help me out here. Henry, thank you. Thank you. Gollum, come here. This is Henry's Gollum.